The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
If I get one more tweet, one more comment on Facebook from somebody saying,
"Well, Larry, Colin has a First Amendment right to say what he wants to say. What's the problem?"
For crying out loud, one more time. I'll speak very slowly for some of you people. This has nothing to do with the First Amendment. The First Amendment prohibits the government from unduly interfering with political speech. And speech can also be gestures, standing up or not standing up, which is why if you are in a public school, the government cannot make you stand up give the Pledge of Allegiance. The government cannot make you do that. But a private actor can. The NBA has a rule that requires players to stand, not only stand, but stand, quote, in the dignified fashion, close quote, for the national anthem. Requires players. There have been a couple of NBA players who didn't do it. They got fined. The NFL has no such rule. So Kaepernick can stand or not stand by permission from the NFL. However, if the NFL and the union negotiated a clause that required the players to stand up, he'd have to stand up. Has nothing whatever to do with the First Amendment because this is involving private actors, not state actors. That's point number one. Point number two. Nobody is saying Colin Kaepernick doesn't have a right. But he doesn't have a right not to be criticized either. So will you please get it straight? And my problem is not that he's standing up. My problem is not that he's being disrespectful. Not just that he's being disrespectful. Not just that he's not standing up. It's that the whole premise of the Black Lives Matter movement is founded on a lie. It was started because of Ferguson, started because of Michael Brown. One more time, he didn't have his hands up. He didn't say don't shoot. The forensic evidence, the eyewitness evidence, the grand jury investigation, the DOJ investigation, both exonerated Officer Darren Wilson. Is this thing on? And I got to tell you, I lose a lot of respect for people, as I did during the O.J. Simpson case, ignoring a mountain of evidence and looking you right in the eye and telling you O.J. didn't do it. Here you have these two investigations, including by the DOJ, under a black president, by the way. Officer Darren Wilson reasonably used deadly force because he was in reasonable fear of his life. Duh. And you're still saying hands up, don't shoot. And never mind that police shootings of blacks are down 75% in 45 years. Twice as many whites are shot by cops as are shot by blacks. You've got that study by that black Harvard economist who says that the police are more likely to use deadly force against whites than against blacks. And that also backs up another study that was published in the Washington Times. Washington State, or a university in Washington State, researchers found the same thing. Cops, black and white, were more reluctant to use deadly force against blacks than against whites. I'm sorry. Meanwhile, in Chicago, the cousin of D'Wayne murdered as she was pushing a baby cart down the street. Chicago is on track for 700 homicides this year. And in a city that's a third black, a third white, and a third Latino, 70% are black against black. And about 75% of them are unsolved. The Washington Post, 965 people killed last year, less than 4% were white officers shooting unarmed black men. And by the way, unarmed does not mean not dangerous. I give you Michael Brown. And I get this letter. It's a bizarre letter. "Dear Larry, listened to your show, heard your story about your dad, and it was a great story and all that, but how do you feel about what happened to Walter Scott? How do you feel about racism in America? How do I feel about Walter Scott? He shouldn't have gotten shot. The officer that did it is being prosecuted for murder. America has had a racist, sexist history, but it has struggled mightily to become a more perfect union. And a more perfect government has never been created. What do you mean, how do I feel about that? I'm Larry Elder, don't leave town.